Hello, my dear students. I am Aditras Chakraborty, lecturer in electrical engineering of Sri Ramakrishna Institute of Science and Technology. Today, I am going to discuss about a three-phase or polyphase system. Today is the first part of my lecture is demonstrated by me. So at first, the advantages of three-phase system over single-phase system. Why we are choosing three-phase system instead of single-phase system? The three-phase system has three live conductors, that means three phases, which supply the 440 volt. Okay, it is the standard voltage, it may be 415 volt also, to the large consumers or industrial consumer, or you can say it is also supply 415 volt to the commercial consumer. While the single phase system has one live conductor, that means one phase and another neutral, which is used for domestic purposes. The following are the main advantage of three-phase system over the single-phase system. So at first, the first one is the higher rating. The rating, that is the output of a three-phase machine, is nearly 1.5 times the rating of a single phase machine of the same size. So if we want to use a three phase of a single phase machine which has the same rating of a three phase machine, we have to choose a bigger size of machine. So the cost of the machine is also increased, and we can efficiently work by a small three-phase machine instead of a single-phase machine of same size and same output, because the output is not same. Actually, size is the same. Output is 1.5 times bigger than the single-phase machine of same size, because there are more numbers of coil and more number of conductors used. So if it is a motor or generator, then a good amount of output can be drawn from a motor or generator. Number two is the constant power. In single phase circuit, the power delivered is pulsating. Even when the voltage and current are in phase, the power is zero twice in each cycle. Whereas the polyphase system, the power delivered is almost constant when the load are in a balanced condition. It is a very important factor. In case of a single phase machine, there is a single phase means there is only one phase. So the sinusoidal curve, we know that the sinusoidal curve has a peak value and a zero value. So when the curve is at zero value, then the voltage and current is also in zero value. In case of resistive circuit also, or in case of unity power factor is also same case happen. So when it is in phase with each other, that means the resistive, in case of resistive load, so at that moment the power is zero. So the power is pulsating. But in case of three phase power, we know the angle between three phases are 0, 120 and 240 degrees. So the angle between three phases are 120 degrees. So if when one phase is at its zero position, the another phase voltage and current is not at zero position. So the less pulsating power can be achieved by the three-phase system, or you can say the constant power can be achieved by a three-phase system. It is a very advantageous fact. So for that very reason, the three-phase system is more advantageous than the single-phase system. Now, the power transmission economics. The three-phase system requires only 75% of the weight of conducting material of that required by the single-phase system to transmit the same amount of power over a fixed distance at a given voltage. So, in case of power transmission economics, it is also advantageous. That means the three-phase system is advantageous than the single-phase system. Size and weight of the alternator. So now we have to compare the single-phase and three-phase alternator. The three-phase alternator is small in size and light in weight as compared to a single-phase alternator. But we can get more output from the alternator, from the three-phase alternator. So it is advantageous. Now, the comparison is between a three-phase induction motor and a single-phase induction motor. The three-phase induction motor have a wide field of application. You can say that in 90% of application, the three-phase induction motor is used in electrical engineering. In the industries, because of the following advantage, three-phase induction motors are self-starting, whereas the single-phase induction motor are not self-starting. It is a very big disadvantage of single-phase induction motor. This means the single-phase motor has no starting torque. Actually, there is a single-phase. That means there is a magnetic flux which is pulsating and alternating but not rotating. So, it is not self-starting. So, you have to use an auxiliary winding or starting winding to start the motor. Okay. Or we have to make a phase angle between two magnetic flux. One is the main flux which is in the main winding and another is the auxiliary flux which is in the auxiliary winding. So, it is difficult to start. It is not self-starting. Hence, it needs some auxiliary means to start at the initial stage. So, it is not advantageous. So the three-phase induction motor is much more advantageous and you can get the more output, mechanical output from a three-phase induction motor also. The three-phase induction motor have higher power factor and efficiency than that of a single-phase induction motor. So, if the three-phase induction motor has a higher power factor, then the power loss is reduced. So, it is much more advantageous than the single-phase induction motor. Now, the requirement of copper and aluminium. Three-phase system required less copper and aluminium for the transmission system in comparison to a single-phase transmission line. Okay. In single-phase transmission line, more amount of copper and aluminium are needed. Actually, when we have to convert the single-phase from three-phase, we have to use the fourth number of conductor, three-phase forward. So, more number of copper and aluminium are required in case of single-phase system. Frequency or vibration. In three-phase motor, the frequency of vibration is less as compared to the single-phase motor. Because in single-phase motor, the power transferred is a function of current and varies constantly. Actually, in case of a single-phase motor, we know the power equals to V into I into cos phi. So, if the current is changed or if the current is varies, then power is also varies. Okay, but in case of the three-phase motor, the power is depends upon the line current. That means root 3 VL into IL into cos phi. So if the phase current is changed, then the line current is also changed, but the effect is lesser than the single phase motor. Okay. So that's all about the advantage of the three-phase power over single-phase system. Okay? Thank you.